Morning friends, welcome to our online education class. In our last period we have seen so many writing skill items. But today we are going to deal with an important topic of writing skill, that is viewed counterly. I think many students get confused while writing view counterly. This is the most difficult question in that manner. Don't worry, we will try to solve it out. View counter view has the weightage of 4 marks in our activity set. So, let us see what exactly view counter view is. Friends, in your college or in your school, many cultural programs are arranged by your school administration or your student council. At that time, elocution, competition or debate also held. And you know, in that program, many students used to participate and talk in the support of a subject or in the oppose of a subject. Okay? So you are familiar with the view counter view in that sense. Secondly, when you switch on any channel, new channel on your TV, at that time you can find there are debates. And many people used to participate in that debate. Some people used to support the issue, the subject, and others used to counter attack that subject. Okay, that is also the part of view counter view. So, view counter view is nothing but the two sides of the same coin. Actually, every issue or subject has many aspects, you know, and nothing is right, completely right or wrong in that aspects. When in your activity set, view section is provided to you and you are asked to develop the counter view. At that time, first of all, you have to understand what is view and what is counter view. Okay. In view section, only points are given to you, and many people or many students used to narrate those points only. There is a pinhead, we can say. So, don't narrate the points as given in the view section of your activity set. So, we have to develop the counter view, mind it well. So, suppose view section and counter view section, I have given some points here. First of all, view section means it is in the favor of the topic with the proper reasons and facts. Okay, view section is in the favor of that subject. Any issue, any subject, maybe political, maybe educational, maybe social, what it may be, that is in the favor of the topic with proper reasons and facts. But you have to develop the counter view, which is opposing the topic, which is in the oppose of the topic with proper reasons and facts. Okay. Secondly, in view section, maybe advantages are given with proper illustrations. At that time, you have to think over the disadvantages of the same subject, and you have to illustrate them with proper explanation. Number three, in view section, positive aspects are given, and so you have to think about the negative aspects of the same subject. Okay, and there is a space, friends, you can add your own points also. There is always a space to add your own points, but the conclusion should be balanced of both view and counter view. Okay, so as you know, there is we can say nothing is completely right or nothing is completely wrong. So you have to balance the conclusion. In this sense, view and counter. View points are given to you and you have to develop the against side, another side of the same coin, of the same subject. Okay. So let us see how to develop a proper counter view. Here I have given some steps or points to be noted. Okay, first of all, you have to look at the title title of the given new section. And after that, you have to try to frame a title just opposite to the given title. Okay, think about that. Maybe a phrase is given, maybe a idiom is given, what it may be, the title in the form of phrase or idiom, what it may be. You have to just think opposite of the title and give a suitable title to your counter view path. The second one, read the given points carefully. The points which are provided in your view section, you have to read them carefully and try to analyze them and try to develop your counter view. Okay, and number three, write a balanced conclusion. So friends, don't make the mistake which often made many students, that don't narrate the points given in the view section. Please again note this point very carefully. You have to develop the counter view, not the view. That means you have to think opposite of the view section, and most of all, do not write your counter view in the point style. Okay, don't write it in the point style. Try to narrate it in the paragraphs. Form the paragraphs and then write your counter view. Many students used to narrate it in the point manner. That is a wrong thing. So you have to narrate it in the format of paragraphs. Okay, so this is view and counter view. I am going to give you an example along with this video, and you can find that the app or proper answer or how to develop a counter view. Okay, so if you have any problem, you can contact me or you can meet me also personally. So try to practice it at home, because this question needs very much practice. So study at home, and if you face any problem, please meet me personally. Thank you then. See you.